I'm going on, Charlie. Time for two of the sweetest words in the English language for any baseball fan. It's opening day, y'all. The 2022 Stetson Hatters are on the field. Head coach Steve Trimper in his sixth year as the head hatter. Thank you for joining us here on Hatter Vision. I'm Asad Bendian. Hatters today playing their first game, not only of the season, but also of the Hatter Classic. Welcoming the Blue Hens of the University of Delaware, a team that only won 12 games last season, a team that is expected to finish mid-pack, basically, in the Colonial, a team that also will be soon without its head coach of 22 years, Jim Sherman, who's walking over to the third base coach's box right now. Will be retiring after the season. His longtime assistant, Dan Hammer, also leaving after the season. We'll go through the starting lineups shortly. Bryce Greenlee will lead off for the Blue Hens, and the first pitch of the year from Danny Garcia is a strike. Danny Garcia, a guy that we're used to seeing in a relief role, gets the starting day nod, partly because of injury. Nick Durgin is dealing with an issue that the coaches are hoping he'll be able to resolve in time for next Friday's game against the Lions of Columbia. Garcia gets the strike call there, 1-2. Garcia, of course, has been a reliever mostly in his time as a Stetson Hatter. Has seen some starts, though, as Greenlee fouls that off. Count remains 1-2. Garcia, a redshirt junior out of Pembroke Pines, fires inside, missing. So put the count 2-2. Garcia with 7 saves last year, which was tied for second in the A-Sun. Also had 3 wins on the year, all of them against teams from the state of Florida. And that'll push the count full. Garcia did see some starts late in the year last year against UNF. So it's not an unfamiliar role for him as Greenlee fouls that off the end of the bat. Count remains full, 3-2. Greenlee, a former Virginia Cavalier, redshirt sophomore, coming in at 6'3", 210. Excuse me there. Greenlee will be in right field today for the Blue Hens. John Weglar is the graduate second baseman. Is in the on-deck circle. Joey Loind, the third baseman, is right behind him. And your payoff is hit into left field. That's Nick DiPonzio's area. He'll grab it for out number one. And let's set Stetson here defensively. Of course, we've been talking about Danny Garcia on the hill. Christian Pregent on the other end, receiving the pitches. First pitch from Garcia to Weglars is fouled away over the third base stands. Around the horn for Stetson, Jacob Bullard at first base, Banks Griffith at second, Kyle Ball at short, Johan Desereau at third. This will go to first, though, which is Bullard. He underhands the Garcia, who covers the bag for out number two. So pretty clean defense there from Stetson for out number two. Jacob Bullard, a name that we've not talked about a whole lot. He was redshirted last season, but the coaches have said he's made great strides over the summer and into the fall and spring, of course. First pitch to Loin is a ball, 1-0. And so much so that Coach Trimper said he basically took the first base job. First First base, as has been the case in recent years for the Hatters, is a position where there's a lot of options for the coaches, as Loin swings through that for strike two. This year, no exception. You'll see Trey Harmon at times at first, the Kentucky transfer. Brandon Hilton as well. The 1-2 is fouled away, backstop netting. Although, from my conversations with Coach Trimper earlier today, it looks like first base is Bullard's job to lose at this point. They feel confident that he can handle the position well, and Danny Garcia gets his first punch out of the year. Loin down swinging, and the Hatters retire the Blue Hens. 1-2-3 to start off game one in this 2022 season, Stetson's 107th baseball season. We head to the bottom of the first. Hats grab the bats. When we come back, you're watching Hatter Vision.
Center fielder number 2, Cameron Hill.
Bottom of the first, we are scoreless between Delaware and Stetson in the first game of the Hatter Classic, the opener for both squads in this 2022 college baseball season. Hatters trotting out Cameron Hill, Kyle Ball, Nick DiPonzio to start us off against Chris Ludman for the Blue Hens. Their ace fires outside 1-0 on Hill. Taking his first swing in a Hatter's uniform is Cameron Hill. He's a transfer from the University of Kentucky. Lefty lets that go by and for the strike. Hill, a redshirt senior from Georgetown, Kentucky, one of two ex-Wildcats on the squad. Trey Harmon's the other. The 1-1 is outside. Hill has dealt with some wrist issues in his collegiate career. It's caused him to miss some time. Coaches are hoping that he can put together a healthy season and a good season as well. They really like his defense. That's in for the strike, so the count now 2-2 on Hill. Of course, he's taking over for Andrew McNeil, who in many ways was Stetson's best player last season, both on defense and on offense, especially on offense in a lot of ways. Of course, there's Hernan Sardinas, but McNeil in his own way was quite good. Lumman buries that pitch, and we've got a full count. Gorgeous weather on this opening day weekend here at Stetson. 82 degrees at first pitch. Bit windy, but not too much. The payoff is hit opposite field, bounces out of the glove of Joey Loin, and that, I imagine, will be a hit. It is the first of the season for the Hatters. And man, Loin came awful close to a spectacular play. Hill doing a nice job going oppo, but hitting it right at Loin, and he just wasn't able to hang on to the hot stuff there. Kyle Ball stepping in. See if Stetson can take advantage of that. Hill pretends like he's going to second. He'll step back. First pitch is a ball, 1-0. Hill has some stolen base ability for sure. He swiped 23 bags in his time at Kentucky. He's a guy that the Hatters are hoping can really set the table offensively for them all year. Ludman throwing over to first. Kyle Ball at the plate right now, a guy that Steve Trimper and company are hoping will take some strides offensively. The 1-0, and Ball backs away. In case you're wondering about the weather, wind out of the west-southwest at 12 miles an hour. Not much of a rain chance, but there's a slight one, 15%. Humidity at 58%, which isn't too bad by Florida standards, actually. The 2-0 hit right up the middle towards the shortstop, the second for one to first. Bit of a high throw, but Delaware executes the 6-4-3 and two outs on the board. So Nick DiPanzio will step in, and let's set the Blue Hens defensively quickly if we can. Chris Ludman on the hill. Nick Vera, the Pittsburgh transfer, behind the plate. Around the horn, it's Joseph Carpenter at first. John Weglars at second. J.J. Freeman at shortstop. Joey Loin, the third baseman. In the outfield, you've got Aiden Kane in left. Bryce Greenlee in right. Jordan Hutchins right between them. Ponzio screams that one foul. That one woke up a few fans in the stands. One ball, one strike now on DiPanzio, the former Demon Deacon. Hoping to get off to a similar start as he did last year. Arguably the Hatters' hottest player throughout the first 10 games of the year or so. That is before he got hurt. The 1-1. Check swing. Ump says he went. So 1-2 on DiPanzio. Nick suffering a leg issue early in the season. It took him a while to recover, and he never really did get his offense going to the same point that he had at the beginning of the year. Still had a solid season, all things considered. 1-2. Big cut. That one gets away from the catcher. But Vera will throw to first to complete the strikeout. So both sides go down 1-2-3. In the first inning of their seasons, we head to the top of the second. No score. You're watching Hattervision.
At this time, ladies and gentlemen, the day report for Woodford Advent Health, the official hospital of Stetson Athletics.
The human body has more than 650 muscles. The only one that never rests is the heart. Maybe that's why true courage never rests either. Advent Health is a proud supporter of the incredible inside.
Heart of the order for the Blue Hens as we start the top of the second. No score for either side. And this is the first game of their respective seasons and the first game of the Hatter Classic. It'll be a weekend full of baseball here at Melching Field. After these two are done, it'll be the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame and the Manhattan Jaspers scoring off. That game's scheduled for a 7 p.m. first pitch. Garcia gets the outside corner. Strike two now on the designated hitter, Jake Dunyon, who didn't play a whole lot last year, but he was awful good when he was in the lineup. Fouls that away. Dunyon finished the year with a .397 batting average. Had just 14 starts. That one right in front of the plate. Pregent throwing to first. And that's out number one.
The first baseman, number 20, Joseph Carpenter.
Dunyon with the ground out there for the first out in the second inning. And here comes Joseph Carpenter. Carpenter led the Blue Hens in homers last year, along with Jack Goen, who's no longer on the roster. Five homers for each of them. Carpenter also drove in 25 runs, which was second on the team to Goen. And Garcia quickly ahead here on the junior first baseman. Nothing in two. Danny working quickly. And the curve. Fans wanted strike three. They're going to have to wait for at least one more. Slow stuff again from Danny, and Carpenter swings through the breaker. Second punch out of the day for Danny Garcia, who so far has looked comfortable in the starting role. As we mentioned earlier, it's one that he has had some experience in, although he's primarily been a reliever in his time at Stetson. Certainly excelled in that reliever role, though. J.J. Freeman, the shortstop, now in. Took a unusual path in a way to D1 baseball to J.J. Freeman, as he's now looking at a 2-0 pitch coming up. Transferred to the Blue Hens from Franklin and Marshall, a Division III school. Hits that right up the middle. And the former D3 guy gets his first hit of the season, and Delaware's first hit of the season, for that matter. This Blue Hens squad, a team with a lot of transfers, 14 to be precise, including two from the University of Pittsburgh. You're looking at one of them right now, and Nick Vera. They also got others from Virginia, Virginia Tech, North Carolina, Kansas State, St. Joseph's, and Delaware State. Not to mention, of course, Freeman from Franklin and Marshall at the D3 level. Garcia's fastball in for the strike. Vera, a sophomore, 5'11", 200 pounds. He's from Florida, Plantation to be precise, in the South Florida area, as that's fouled up and away. Played his high school ball at St. Thomas Aquinas, one of the high school powerhouses in the South Florida area, before making his move to Pitt and then also making a stop at the JUCO level at Tallahassee Community College. No score here. Line score the same for both sides, though, 0-1 and 0. And the 0-2, and Vera goes down swinging for strike three. So two innings, six outs, and three Ks for Danny Garcia, looking sharp so far in this opening day game for the green and white. We head to the bottom of the second. Still scoreless. You're watching Hatter Vision.
Stetson Hatter fans, Bud Light is proud to be the official beer of Stetson University. Making friends is Bud Light's business. And as part of this, Bud Light wants to remind everyone that choosing a designated driver
is what good friends do. Bud Light, Daytona Beverages, and Stetson University. Thanks everyone for making a responsible choice in choosing a designated driver. At Main Street Community Bank of Florida, community is our middle name. Just like the Stetson Hatters are our hometown team, Main Street is your hometown lender. You'll work with local lenders, making local decisions. Decisions that support your community. Main Street Community Bank of Florida. Familiar name, familiar faces, familiar bank. All loans are subject to credit approval. Member FDIC, equal housing lender. Fourth, the designated hitter, number 30, Trey Harmon.
Bottom of the second. Thank you for joining us on Hatter Vision in the opening game of the 2022 season for Stetson Hatters baseball, taking on the Blue Hens of the University of Delaware. Heart of the order here for the green and white, Trey Harmon, Johan Desereau, Jake Bullard all due up. Chris Lundman in his second inning of work. And he'll fire that low and outside on Harmon. 1-1 the count. Harmon, a right-handed hitter. Transfer from the University of Kentucky. A guy that the coaches feel could really hit well offensively in a ballpark like Melching. Fouls that one off the top of the first base dugout screen there, 1-2. Harmon, a guy who looks country strong, as you can see there. Coaches feel like he can really drive the ball into the gaps at Melching Field. This is, of course, a rather large ballpark. The 1-2 in the dirt. In case you're not familiar with the dimensions, 335 down the lines, 375 to the gaps, 403 to straight center. This park can play a little bigger than that sometimes, though, especially if the wind is blowing in the right direction, which is to say the wrong direction, if you want to hit a ball out of here, that is. The 2-2 is in the dirt, full count. The wind today, though, not really conducive to that sort of thing. It's blowing basically across from right to left. Generally, at Melching, when the homers go out of here, you usually see the wind blowing out over the right field fence. Payoff, misses outside corner, and Harmon draws the walk. So the first pass of the year goes to the former Wildcat. And here comes one of two Canadians on the Hatters roster, Johan Desereau from Quebec originally. First pitch for him, up the middle, off the second base bag, and Harmon's thinking he wants to go to third. The throw is high and over the third baseman's head. That's going to allow Desereau to move up another 90 feet. I imagine we're going to see at least one E called on that one. Desereau definitely getting the single there. So give Stetson their second hit of the game. I imagine that will be a throwing error, allowing both runners to advance. We're still waiting for the official ruling, though. In the meantime, here comes Jake Bullard. No error on the play. Just advanced the second on the throw for Desereau, and Harmon as well advancing to third. So no E on the board as Jake Bullard looks at the first pitch strike, 0-1. Bullard, one of two players on this roster from New Hampshire. Nick Ball's the Kyle Ball is the other, is what I meant to say. The 0-1. Bullard fouls, tips that to the backstop padding. 0-2. Bullard redshirted last year, basically a non-factor on the team, a guy that didn't come in with a whole lot of expectations to Stetson. He was a walk-on last year, actually. But he made a real big jump over the summer in a lot of ways, especially in ability, the 0-2. And he opposites fouls that one. That'll go off the roof of the hitting pavilion. Talking to Coach Trimper before the game, he was raving about how Bullard had really improved himself, not only over the summer, but in fall ball and in the training camp leading up to the regular season, saying essentially that he earned the job at first base, which was no small feat considering there's a lot of competition there right now. The 0-2. And he foul tips that one off. First base over the last few years for Stetson has been a position of riches, really, for the Hatters. Of course, they got a huge hole to fill there with Hernan Sardinius leaving after he had a monster season. Brandon Hilton, also a guy who will see time at first. He's sitting out today dealing with a hip issue. Coaches hope to have him back pretty soon. The 0-2, outside corner, and Ludman wanted it. Oh, he wanted that corner. He didn't get it, though. 1-2. Ludman, a graduate, originally from Newark, Delaware, resuming his spot on the Blue Hens roster as their Friday guy. Runners at second and third. The 1-2, and Bullard keeps fouling pitches off. Bullard only had one at bat all last year, actually. And that was a strikeout. The 1-2. And that's hit towards short. That should play to run. Freeman with the throw over to first. Bullard's retired. But Trey Harmon scores from third. And the Hatters strike first. It's 1-0. Desereau moving up to third on the play, so we've got another runner at third here for Connor Keel, the senior from Minnesota. First pitch for him, and that was almost his first RBI of the year. Went oppo there, and it just landed foul. Keel from Eden Prairie, Minnesota, a guy who will usually, when he's in the lineup, be in one of the corner outfield spots, right field today. 5'11", 185 is how he stands. Saw action in 20 games last year for Stetson, .242 batting average. Usually a guy who was in the lineup when other outfielders were injured. That ball gets away from from Vera. Desereau not able to move up on the play, though. Actually, I think I might have been right the first time. I think that pitch got away from both Ludman and Vera in their own respective ways. Keel saw a lot of his action last year, I know, when DiPonzio was hurt. And injuries in general were a problem for Stetson last season, especially on the mound. The 1-1. And Keel hits that hard in the right field. That should play Desereau at least. Greenlee's there, makes the grab. Desereau tags. He'll come in standing up. And the Hatters lead 2-0. So the sack works, and the Hatters are up 2-0 as Christian Pregent will step in. This Hatter squad has four captains on its roster. You're looking at one of them. Preachin has been a captain pretty much since he got to Stetson as a true freshman. Extremely rare honor, of course, for a player who is still trying to learn his way around campus and, you know, where the classes are, but that's how much the coaches thought of him and how much his teammates do, too, for that matter. Preachin, a redshirt sophomore, 6'3", 215, originally from the Daytona Beach area. Played his high school ball in Atlantic High. The 0-1. That misses outside. One ball, one strike to count. Stetson, of course, being located in Volusia County. They don't get a whole lot of players from Volusia County, though. Preachin, one of the few on the roster. Candon Traficante, another. He's from Ormond Beach. The 1-1. Ludman gets outside corner there. Ludman right now at over 30 pitches in this game. He's a guy who's used to going the distance in games, though. Or he can, anyway. That pitch is in the dirt. Two balls, two strikes. Delaware last year had three complete games. Ludman had all of them. He's been a regular starter for the Blue Hens since 2018. 9 wins in his Delaware career versus 17 losses. The 2-2 in the dirt again as Ludman keeps throwing it short of the plate. And that'll be a payoff now for Preachin, a batter that the Hatter coaches hope will take some steps up offensively. They love his defense. And they want to keep him in the lineup for that reason alone. And that's a bouncer towards third. Loin charging, gathers. Throw across the diamond, side retired. But the Hatters do manage to strike first. Jacob Bullard on an RBI ground out. And Connor Keel with a pop out the right field, driving in. Johan Desereau Harmon coming in on Bullard's ground out. And we head to the top of the third with the score. Stetson 2, Delaware nothing. You're watching Hatter Vision.
We continue to make selling your home easier and safer than ever. Simply contact a Watson Realtor to discuss your goals and determine your home's value. Then we'll market to ideal buyers and arrange for tours that match everyone's comfort level. Best of all, though we've adapted our methods to a new environment, we still offer legendary service and get your home sold. Sell the Watson way. Simple, safe, sold.
Nothing can stop me. I'm all the way up.
Batting eighth, the center fielder, number 2, Jordan Hutchins.
Bottom of the lineup card now for Jim Sherman's squad as we begin the top of the third. Stetson 2, Delaware nothing. Hutchins fouls that away. Over the first base stands. Fairly good crowd for the first game of the year at Stetson, considering it's 3 p.m. on a Friday. As Hutchins fouls that away, 0-2 to count. The start time, a bit unusual for Stetson in their opening game of the year. Generally, they do the opening night thing, usually around 6:30, 7 o'clock. Coach is opting for a bit of a switch-up this year. The 1-2, and that's a high chopper towards third. Two bounces, there's ball. throw to first, but Bullard got the tag, even though the throw threw him up, put him off the bag. So Hutchins retired on the ground out the short. And that'll bring up Aiden Kane. That was a nice play there from Bullard, I must say. That throw was offline from Ball, and Bullard had to really come off the bag and stretch to apply the tag, or otherwise Hutchins absolutely would have made it the first. Kane is the ninth batter in the order for Delaware. Lefty lays off of that. 1-1 the count. Danny Garcia already at over 30 pitches in this game as he fires outside. 2-1. Kane, one of only two lefties in the lineup today for the Blue Hens. J.J. Freeman's the other. And Kane hits that towards second. There's Banks Griffith. And the former Furman Paladin throws a clean the first for out number two. So now we cycle back to the top, and Bryce Greenlee I really love it when we play the cartoon theme songs. It's the best. Garcia fires low, 1-0. That's a thing that the music pickers here at Stetson will do on occasion. Two and zero the count. So don't be surprised if you hear, let's say, Little Einsteins or some others. And that one hit towards third. Desero not able to pick it cleanly. And Greenlee will make it to first. And let's see what the ruling is there. I believe it'll be a hit. Well, that ball definitely touched Desero's glove and bounced away. So let's see how generous the scorekeeper's feeling today. As Weglar steps in, the graduate second baseman, the only switch hitter on the lineup today for the Blue Hens, hits that towards second. His counterpart, Banks Griffith, is right there. Bullard managed to pick it off the dirt, even though it fell out of his glove in time, and the side is retired. So, not the cleanest defense, but the Hatters get away with it. And by the way, Greenlee reached on a single, so give Delaware two hits on the day. We head to the bottom of the third with the Hatters up two. You're watching Hatter Vision.
Book your next stay in advance and save up to 15% off the already great rates. Hampton Inn & Suites Deland, an official hotel partner of your Stetson Hatters. Fans, Geico offers a special discount on car insurance to Stetson alumni. Just visit geico.com to get a free quote and select Stetson alum to see how much you can save. Don't drop the ball when it comes to saving money. Contact Geico today.
Time for the final Hatter batter to get his first AB of the 2022 season. Banks Griffith, the second baseman, with the zero on his back. And then we cycle back to the top. First pitch for Griffith, hit towards short. J.J. Freeman's there. Throw across, and Carpenter doing a nice job grabbing the ball there and tagging Griffith for out number one. I guess he figured if he saw Jake Bowler do it in the top of this inning, why not do it himself, right? The throw from Freeman a bit offline. Carpenter with a nice job picking that one off and tagging Bullard. So now it's Cameron Hill, the center fielder, reached on a single in the first. Ludman gets the strike. And then Hill got erased on the 6-4-3 double play from Kyle Ball. Ludman, first base side of the rubbers where he's set up, and Hill will foul that over the third base stands here. So put the count 0-2. That's a bouncer toward second. Weglars is there. Throw to first in time for out number two.
Now the shortstop, number 13, Kyle Ball.
Both teams still trying to feel their way offensively. Although it is Stetson with the early lead in this game, thanks to the two runs in the bottom of the second. The RBI ground out by Jake Bullard and the RBI popper by Connor Keel. Kyle Ball, first pitch. Nubber right to the first baseman. Carpenter's there. He'll step on the bag, and that will do it. 1-2-3 go the Hatters in the bottom of the third. We are through three innings here at Melching Field. The Hatters up two on Delaware. You're watching Hatter Vision.
Patrick Mazika of the New York Mets and Logan Gilbert of the Seattle Mariners. Welcome back, and thank you for attending here this afternoon.
Love Stetson Athletics? Then join the team behind the team and donate to the Hatter Athletic Fund to keep your Stetson Hatters at the top of elite competition. If you are interested in donating to provide opportunities for Stetson student athletes, log on to GoHatters.com and click on the Hatter Athletic Fund link in the Support the Hatters tab.
Third baseman number 29, Joey Lowe.
As we return here to the top of the fourth, you might recognize those two on your screen. Logan Gilbert and Patrick Mazika, both taking a little time away from their pro baseball duties to catch a little Hatters baseball on a field where, of course, they both starred for many years here at Stetson. Of course, the reason they're here, well, we're not going to go into that. 3, 4, and 5 hitters for the Blue Hens due up here. Joey Loin swinging through the off speed there for strike two. Loin is 0-for-1 in this game. He K'd in the first, one of three so far in this game for Danny Garcia. And the fastball's outside corner 1-2. Danny Garcia so far in this game has been pretty clean. Over 40 pitches right now. And he gets his fourth K of the day. Loin swinging through the breaker for strike three. All four Ks of the swinging variety for Danny Garcia. And as of right now, the junior from Pembroke Pines has faced two above the minimum in this game. Jake Dunyon, the designated hitter, steps in. Now looking at a 1-0 count. Dunyon grounding out to the catcher in the second inning on a ball that maybe went 5 feet in front of home plate before Preachin picked it up and threw it the first. Dunyan from Wilmington, Delaware, redshirt sophomore. Fouls that up and away. Well, second team all CAA last year, also made the Colonials all rookie team. Didn't play a whole lot, but he was really good when he was, especially at the plate. Count now, 3 balls and a strike on Dunyan. Preacher wants that one up the middle, and Dunyan hits that up the middle. Right over Kyle Ball's head and into the outfield for Delaware's third hit of this game. So that's the third inning in a row where Delaware's gotten a hit. They've not been able to do much with it, though. As a matter of fact, the Blue Hens haven't gotten a runner past first base in this game. Now, Joseph Carpenter, the junior first baseman, steps in. He's Delaware's biggest returning bat in terms of power. 5 homers last year, 25 RBI. Definitely has some pop. From Cornwall, Pennsylvania is Joseph Carpenter. 6'2", 220 is how he stands. Dunyan with a decent lead at first. And Carpenter goes opposite field, and that's driven all the way into the corner. This might plate one. Keel gathering it up. Throwing to the cutoff man. The throw is towards third as Dunyan comes home all the way from first. And the Blue Hens cut the lead. It's 2-1. So give Carpenter the RBI double. I warned you about the kids' music, folks. As you can see, our music pickers have a little bit of a sense of humor. J.J. Freeman steps in, the shortstop. He got Delaware's first single of the year in the second. Hits that into center field. Cameron Hill's there. Into the gap, makes the catch. Runner tagging from second. And Carpenter will make it to third safely. So J.J. Freeman moves Carpenter up 90 feet, and that'll bring up Nick Vera, the catcher. At this point, I'm just waiting for Baby Shark. First pitch to Vera. Popped up, left field. DiPonzio's there. Side retired. But Delaware does dent the scoreboard. An RBI double from Joseph Carpenter, bringing home Jake Dunyan all the way from first. And as we enter the bottom of the fourth, it's Stetson 2, Delaware 1. You're watching Hattervision.
Corporate identity shop. Find everything you need for your business, from printing, apparel, signs, vehicle graphics, promotional products, and more. ImageWorks, proud sponsor of the Hatters. To reach your goals on the field or court, you need strong support from the sidelines. Advent Health is proud to partner with the Hatters in their whole person, health, body, mind, and spirit. Visit adventhealth.com to learn more. Advent Health, the official hospital of Stetson Athletics.
Baby, I'm too busy counting how you pass. Gotta send it,
Leading off the bottom of the fourth inning, the left fielder, number 11, Nick DiPanzio.
Bottom of the fourth. Hatters, two runs, two hits, no errors. The Blue Hens, one run, four hits, and no errors. Been a tight one so far in the first game of the Hatter Classic, the opening to the 2022 baseball season for both sides. And thank you, as always, for joining us here on Hatter Vision. I'm Asad Bendian. In case you're wondering, we've got a nice crew of guys making sure that we keep everything in line for you as you're watching today's game. Cameraman extraordinaire Charlie Franklin. He's the guy who's making sure that lens stays focused for you. 2-0 count. Big cut from DiPanzio. And that puts the count 2-1. We also have someone else assisting us today on the broadcast, the name that some of you Hatter fans might be aware of. You may have heard of him once or twice. The 2-1, and DiPanzio fouls, tips that away. So the count now 2-2 on the former Demon Deacon. And in case you're not sure who I'm talking about, I'm referring to Donald Parham. He's helping us produce today's game, so. Two and two to count. DiPanzio with a bouncer over the pitcher's hand. Freeman with a nice play, but not enough time for him to throw to first. And DiPanzio hustles his way on for Stetson's third hit of this contest. And that is now three times in the last four innings where Stetson's leadoff batter has reached. Hill got erased on a double play in the first. Harmon's walk in the second eventually led to him scoring the first run of the year for the Hatters. And speaking of Harmon, he's the one now up. First pitch, and Trey swings through that for strike one. Trey Harmon, 6'4", 235 from Somerset, Kentucky. Saw some action in his time at Lexington, but primarily a bench guy for the Wildcats. Ludman with the sidearm throw to first to keep DiPanzio honest. Trey, in case you're wondering, that is actually not his real first name. French Baker Harmon III is his real name, as DiPanzio flies towards second, makes it safely. He almost shot the bag at second, actually. He had to put that hand out to make sure he didn't overslide, or otherwise he would have been out. But DiPanzio, he's got wheels. That's his first swipe of the year. DiPanzio, part of an off-field crew that Coach Trimper feels like could be the best he's ever had in his time at Stetson defensively. A lot of guys out there who can really cover some serious range. DiPanzio's a guy who's played center in his time here at Stetson, so he definitely does not lack for range. The 1-2. Big cut from Harmon. That got away from the catcher, though. Harmon's going to have to hustle at first, and he won't beat it. Bit of a sloppy throw, but Carpenter managed to grab it anyway for out number one. And DiPanzio takes advantage, of course, to move up to third on the play. So with one out on the board, Johan Desero with an excellent chance to get his first RBI as a Stetson Hatter. As Harmon goes down swinging, that is the second K of the day for Chris Ludman. But he's already given up two runs, and he's in danger of a third here as the Blue Hens infield draws in. First pitch, Desero laces it to right field. The throw home will not be in time. DiPanzio scores on the sacrifice from Desero, and it's 3-1 Hatters. Nice grab from Greenlee. Low liner that almost hit the ground, but managed to snag it just in time. So far in this game, the Hatters have been trading outs for runs. All three runs so far coming on and out. First pitch, Bowler goes oppo field. That will go foul. And he was already thinking two in his head as he was making that wide turn. But the Granite State native, he'll just have to walk his way back to the plate. Take at least one more swing. Bullard, still a freshman, entering his, he was actually redshirted last season, so technically a redshirt freshman. 6'1", 205 from Hampton, New Hampshire. He'll hit that oppo field, and this time it stays fair. As Bullard gets his first hit of the season. Hard hit ball that John Weglars at second base couldn't do a whole lot with. That'll bring up Connor Keel, the right fielder. Jake Bullard, a guy that you can expect to see a lot in the lineup this year, especially if he keeps hitting like that. Coach Trimper talking with media just before the season began, saying that he wants to see this team become a lot more aggressive offensively. Bullard, a guy that will be one of those, I suspect, from his approach at the plate. 0-1 the count on Connor Keel. He drove in Stetson's second run of this game on a popper to right that plated Desereau. That coming in the second. Keel up the middle. That bounced off the mound and in the center. So the Hatters trying to generate a little two-out magic here. Back-to-back singles for Bullard, and now Keel brings up Christian Pregent. Pregent entering his third year as one of the captains on this Stetson baseball team. Made the A-Sun All-Freshman team last year. Coach is raving about his defense. They're hoping that the bat will make significant strides this year. As Ludman fires high, 1-0. No action in the Blue Hens' pen, in case you're wondering. I'm sure Jim Sherman and company probably do not want to have to dip into the pen a little too early. They got a lot of baseball ahead of them. The 1-0. Letter high for the strike. You're going to see two games a day here at Melching Field this weekend as part of the Hatter Classic. Game two tonight will be Notre Dame in Manhattan, 7 o'clock first pitch. And then tomorrow, it'll be Stetson-Notre Dame, followed by Manhattan-Delaware. Actually, my apologies. It'll be Manhattan-Delaware first at noon, followed by Stetson-Notre Dame at 4 o'clock. And then the two Sunday games will be early ones, Delaware-Notre Dame at 9 a.m., Stetson and Manhattan to close things off at 1 o'clock, as, of course, Sunday will be a travel day for most of the teams in this tournament. Excepting Stetson, of course. 2-1 count on Pregent. And he'll bounce that foul towards Steve Trimper in the third base coach's box. So the count now 2-2 on Pregent. Coach Trimper overseeing a lot of changes to the Stetson roster this year. And also in the coach's room, the 2-2. And that's fouled up and away. Two new assistants coming into the program. And Shane Gerke and Shane Opitz. Joe Mercandante making his way to Pittsburgh. And the volunteer assistant last year and for a couple of years, actually, Brandon Brewer making his way south, where he's now with the Miami Hurricanes. Bowler at second, Keel at first. The 2-2. And Pregent's down swinging. So give Ludman his third K in this game. But not before the Hatters plate one run. They get it back. Thanks to Desereaux's RBI lineout plating Nick DiPonzio. We head to the fifth. Stetson 3, Delaware 1. You're watching Hatter Vision.
And this time we look to the video board for a word from Florida Orthopedics.
Inside us all is an athlete. On the field, the gym, the track, the court, at any age, any activity, injuries happen. Their pain is keeping you from being active. Turn to Florida Orthopedic Associates. We offer standing or next day appointments and walk-in ortho clinics in Orange City and Fairmont. Using the latest technology and minimally invasive procedures, our experts are uniquely qualified to get you back in the game. For more than 50 years, we provide orthopedic care in our community. Florida Orthopedic Associates is proud to be the team physicians for Stetson University and other local athletic bodies.
Now batting the center fielder number 2, Jordan Hutchins.
Top of the fifth. 8-9-1 hitters for the Blue Hens due up. As Danny Garcia fires high. 0-1 the count. Garcia at this point in the game has thrown 55 pitches. Pretty clean for the most part as it's bounced towards short. But Desereaux, the third baseman, will pick it. Nice, strong sidearm throw for out number one. Desereaux ranging nicely to make that play. Desereaux, one of two freshmen in the starting lineup today. The other one is actually the one that he threw the ball to there on that play, Jake Bullard. Coaches are hoping to see a lot of offense from Desereaux this year. He's a guy whose bat they love. As that's fouled up and away. Third base last year was a bit of a juggling act for the Hatters. Jackson Olson spent time there. Banks Griffith spent time there as well after Olson got hurt. Danny Garcia buries that pitch. And Garcia fires that low at the feet of Kane, 2-0. Kane 0-for-1 in this game. He grounded out to second base. That coming into third. And he'll hit that hard in the center field. Hill looking over his right shoulder near the fence, but he can't corral it. It bounced off the glove. And Kane will keep himself at second. Let's see the ruling there. I would say very possible the first error of the game. That bounced off of Hill's glove, clearly. Wasn't the easiest play, though. He was staring at the sun and running towards a fence that was creeping up on him pretty rapidly. The ruling is a double. So, for the first time all game, Delaware with a runner in scoring position. As we cycle back to the top and Bryce Greenlee. Garcia gets the strike call, 0-1. I suspect the wind might have also caused some issues for Hill out there, the way it's streaming right now. Throw over to second. Banks Griffith. Hoping he can catch Aiden Kane napping. But the ump said no. Our men in blue today, by the way. That was Hank Himinen, who who ranged over to second. He'll be the first base ump. Kevin Flay over at third. Nathaniel Starr calling the balls and strikes. And he'll call that a strike. So the count now 0-2 on Greenlee, who's 1-for-2 in this game. Singled in the third, popped out to left field in the first. Griffith will back away from second. That one hit towards the hole at short and third. Desereau dove. He couldn't get it. And another hit here for the Blue Hens as they're starting to mount a threat. Three Blue Hens in his starting lineup today are graduates. You're looking at one of them in John Weglars, who's 0-for-2 today. Ground outs to first and second, respectively, in the first and third innings. Jake Bullard playing the bag at first. The Hatters hoping to get a double play and get out of this jam. Runner going. Preget will not throw. As Greenlee takes the bag uncontested. One out on the board here in the top of the fifth as Garcia gets the strike call. Hatter's bullpen is starting to stir to life now. A lot of pitchers over there getting their stretch on. Preget wants this outside. That goes between first and second for a base hit. It'll plate at least one. The throw to home is cut off, and this game is tied. Aiden Kane, Bryce Greenlee, all scoring from third and second, respectively. The two RBI hit from Weglars knots this game at 3. Three hits in a row now for the Blue Hens. They now have 7 in this game. Stetson trying to stop the bleeding here. Garcia's strike. Makes it 0-1 now. Lots of action on this Friday, as you might imagine. The opening weekend of the college baseball season. The 0-1. In for the strike. So the count now 0-2 on Joey Loyne, who hasn't had a whole lot of success so far today. 2 Ks in the first and in the fourth, respectively. Garcia taking his time here. The 0-2 is popped out of play. Early in the season, so I can't imagine we're going to see Danny stretched out for a whole lot longer. Throw over to first. But Danny is a guy who is used to going longer than you might think he would for a guy who spent a lot of his career in relief for Stetson. The 0-2. Hit hard in the center. Not very deep, though. Hill, ranging back, makes the grab.
Visiting hitter, number 9, Jake Dunyon.
And with 2 outs on the board now, here comes the designated hitter, Jake Dunyon. Dunyon, a guy who was a pretty good player in high school, first team all Delaware. Fastball from Garcia's high, 1-0. Delaware last year, 12 wins and 22 losses, including 8-16 in Colonial play. They faced some challenges last year for sure, though, as the 1-0 is hit in the right field. That's tailing towards the foul line, and in foul territory is where it will land. Weglars was on his horse from first. He'll have to go all the way back. Last year, the Blue Hens didn't play a single midweek game. COVID protocols being the main reason. Travel restrictions as well due to COVID. The 1-1 is a fastball high, 2-1. And one thing we should also note that I don't think we have at this point in the broadcast. Delaware head coach Jim Sherman going for his 800th career win as a head coach. Most of those at Delaware, not all though. He did spend some time at the D2 level as a head coach. That one hit hard towards short. Kyle Ball's right there. Snatches it out of the air. Side retired. But not before the Blue Hens find a way to knot this game up. John Weglars with a 2-RBI single makes it 3-3. Bottom of the fifth coming up. You're watching Hatter Vision.
Love Stetson Athletics? Then join the team behind the team and donate to the Hatter Athletic Fund to keep your Stetson Hatters at the top of elite competition. If you are interested in donating to provide opportunities for Stetson student athletes, log on to GoHatters.com and click on the Hatter Athletic Fund link in the Support the Hatters tab.
Want to stay up to date on all things happening in Hatter Nation? Follow us on our Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram accounts at Stetson Hatters. Your destination for in-game stats, student-athlete features, game promotions, and more. Follow at Stetson Hatters today.
Bottom of the lineup card starting us off here in the bottom of the fifth. It's Banks Griffith for the Hatters. Cameron Hill, Kyle Ball also due up for Steve Trimper's squad. We're rocking a new uniform for this game. Ludman fires inside for the strike on Griffith, 0-1. Hatters with a new look white uni. Dark green letters with light green trim around the letters and number as Griffith fouls that away and the count now 0-2. Griffith still looking for his first hit of the game and the season, grounded out to short in the third, swinging on the first pitch. Griffith, the guy who will be aggressive at the plate, the coaches like that about him. They want him swinging early in the count. The 0-2. And that one tapped towards short. That's J.J. Freeman, out number one.
Center fielder, number two.
So two straight at-bats for Griffith where he grounds out the short. And we're back to the top in Cameron Hill. Hill grounding out the second the last time in the third. Reached on a single in the first, but then was erased on a 6-4-3 double play. About an hour and change into this contest. A game where neither side has really stretched too far away from the other. Stetson at one point leading 2-0. They've been trading runs ever since, though, as Hill hits that. Hard in the center. On the run is the center fielder. Hutchins will not make it. And Hill gets his second hit of the day. Hill, a guy who was a 250 hitter when he played for the Kentucky Wildcats. Saw plenty of action in his 3 years there. Elite defensive tools. The coaches are hoping that he can improve that average a little more and get on base a whole lot, because he can definitely swipe bags, throw over to first. As you might be able to see, he's wearing that big black mitt on his left hand. That's to help keep the fingers from getting jammed up should he slide into base like that. That hand being his glove hand, of course. Kyle Ball now in. Still waiting for a pitch. He's 0 for 2 today. Lays off of that one, which was basically at his feet, 1-0. Hill's going. Hit and run on. Ball had to lunge awkwardly at that pitch. I don't know if that was really a hit and run or if Ball was just trying to duck out of the way. I think it actually, he might have been just trying to duck out of the way. Definitely swung at that one a little weird. One ball now, one strike on Kyle Ball, who likes Stetson hats, as you can tell if you're watching the scoreboard here at Melching. Sometimes the guys like to have a little fun when they're doing their preseason video shoot. That's where a lot of the video graphics come from. If you ever come watch games at Melching and you're wondering where those videos come from that are on the scoreboard, it's a shoot that the team does before the season begins. That one hit hard towards short. 6-4-3 for the second time in this game. Kyle Ball hits into a double play. And that retires the Hatters here. We're through 5 at Melching. And we were where we began. Tied. You're watching Hatter Vision.
Dr. Sarah Altier. Happy birthday, Dr. Sarah Altier. Also, fans, don't forget that tomorrow is the 3rd annual special ride to the park. The special ride will begin at 2:30 p.m. on Hubbard Avenue. Be sure to join us. It's the 3rd annual special ride to the park. Tomorrow, 2:30 p.m. on Hubbard Avenue. At this time, let's look at the video board for word from Florida Public Utility.
Ask for gas. Ask for gourmet meals. Ask for endless hot water. For faster drying times. Ask for natural gas. Ask for appliances that last longer. Ask for more comfort. For higher return on your home's value. Ask for hurricane ready. For hot meals and hot showers and a power outage. Ask for benefits. Ask for energy savings. Ask for rebates. Ask for more. Ask for natural gas.
Leading off the top of the 6th inning, the first baseman, number 20, Joseph Carpenter.
We're in the 6th inning here at Melching Field, a gorgeous day for baseball here in DeLand, Florida. 5, 6, and 7 due up here for the Blue Hens, rocking their black tops and blue pinstriped white pants. Garcia gets the strike on the outside, 0-1. Carpenter in this game with an RBI double in the 4th, he K'd in the 2nd. He's quickly down 0-2. And this is the kind of rhythm that Danny Garcia likes to get into. Get ahead in the count and keep him guessing. Outside corner, strike three. First K looking in this game for Danny Garcia. And you can give him five in this contest. And that'll bring up J.J. Freeman, one of two lefties in the lineup for Jim Sherman. There's also Weglars, who's a switch hitter. As Freeman fouls that away. Making a big jump in class is Freeman. Played last year at Franklin and Marshall, a D3 school. One of the best players at that level, though, across all of D3. Talking to Coach Sherman before the game, he mentioned that, you know, he felt that Freeman could handle playing at this level. That's a pop-up towards left field. DiPanzio makes the grab.
Now batting the catcher, number 44, Nick Vera.
And with two outs on the board, here comes Nick Vera. A sophomore from Plantation. 5'11", 200 is how he stands. Making his way to Delaware after stops at Tallahassee Community College and the University of Pittsburgh. And Vera looks at the strike there, 0-1. He is 0-2 today, Vera. Cade in the second, popped out to left in the fourth. And quickly down 0-2. Garcia looking for a 1-2-3 inning. He'll get it. Vera down swinging. That's the 6K of the game for Danny Garcia. And after two straight innings where he allowed at least a run, Garcia steadies the ship here in the sixth. We head to the bottom of the sixth. We're tied at three. You're watching Hatter Vision.
Making friends is Bud Light's business. And as part of this, Bud Light wants to remind everyone that choosing a designated driver is what good friends do. Bud Light, Daytona Beverages, and Stetson University. Thanks everyone for making a responsible choice in choosing a designated driver.
Leading off the bottom of the sixth inning for your Hatters, left fielder number 11, Nick DiPanzio.
The sounds of Crazy Town leading us back here in the bottom of the sixth. 3, 4, and 5 for Steve Trimper's ball club. Nick DiPanzio, Trey Harmon, Johan Desero. Thank you for joining us here on opening day at Melching Field. I'm Asad Bendian, Charlie Franklin manning our camera, Donald Parm helping us produce today's broadcast. Thank you all for your efforts and making sure this is as smooth as can be. Hatters baseball team locked in a tight one here with Delaware as we're knotted at 3 runs each. Seven hits for the Blue Hens, 6 for the Hatters. Error-free ball on both sides. The count now 1-1. 1-1, I should say, on DiPonzio, who had a single in the fourth, Cade in the first. DiPonzio would eventually score in the fourth inning on Desereaux's lineout. All 3 Stetson runs in this game coming by sacrifice. DiPonzio, a guy that in his Stetson career has shown the ability to get off to a hot start. He did last year before an injury sidelined him. The 1-2 in the dirt. 2-2 to count. Coach Tremper saying before the season began that DiPonzio is a streaky kind of guy, and when he's hot as anybody can get. That's certainly true. He had the hot bat last year before he got hurt. That one hit towards second. The throw to first in time. That was not an easy play for J.J. Freeman. That ball hit off the bag. And he had to really hustle to get the DiPonzio. Matter of fact, when it hit the bag, I was pretty sure that was going to be a single for Nick, but credit to Freeman, he fielded it cleanly. And here comes Trey Harmon, designated hitter. First pitch swinging for him is a high chopper that goes off the roof of the third base dugout. Harmon walked in the second, eventually scored on Jake Bullard's RBI ground out to short. The 0-1. Inside corner strike there, 0-2. Chris Lumman, by the way, at over 80 pitches at this point in the game. That's in the dirt. Appeal to first denied. Harmon managing to hold the bat up there. 1-2 to count. Harmon, who is going for his MBA here at Stetson, transferring, of course, from SEC country, Kentucky in his case. In his 3 years as a Wildcat, had a .274 batting average along with 6 homers and 22 RBIs. Didn't play a whole lot. And now he's down swinging, down looking, I should say, for strike 3. So give Ludman his 4th K of the day. That's the first one looking, actually. Harmon down on the 1-2. And that'll bring up Johan Desereaux. And the Canadian goes swinging first pitch, missing 0-1. Desereaux singled in the second. First pitch for him, actually. Then lined out to right field, but it drove in a run. The final run in this game so far for Stetson. And Desereaux down quickly here, 0-2. Desereaux is one of 2 Canadians on this team. Simon Lusignan the other, although you won't see Lusignan this year because he's redshirting. And Desereaux tried the golf swing at that one. Fell out of the catcher's mitt, so the throw to first necessary to complete the strikeout. So Ludman now with 5 Ks through 6 innings. And as we enter the final third of this game, we're still not sure who's going to win it. We're tied at 3. You're watching Hatter Vision.
Today.
the top of the seventh inning, the center fielder number two, Jordan Hutchins.
Top of the seventh, 8-9-1 for Jim Sherman's Delaware Blue Hens. Hutchins swings through the high stuff right there, 0-1 the count. We've got action in the Hatter's pen. First, second pitch to Hutchins is a high popper. It'll be Kyle Ball in short.
And out of left fielder number 25, Aiden Kane.
And that's out number one. Here in this seventh, Hutchins now 0-3 in this game. Popping out on the 0-1. We got a righty and a lefty warming up for Stetson. As Garcia's first pitch is in for a strike. Anthony DeFabia looks like he's warming up. He's the lefty in the pen for Stetson. Caden hitting that one hard in the right field, but not very deep. Connor Keel will be there, and he'll grab it for out number two.
To the top of the order for the right fielder, number one, Bryce Greenlee.
Danny Garcia working quickly right now. He's about to hit 90 pitches in this game, which is definitely not bad considering we're in the top of the seventh. He hasn't had a whole lot of long innings, the fifth being the longest where he faced six batters. Greenlee ducking out of the way of that one. Count now 1-1 on the sophomore right fielder with two singles in the day. The third and the fifth, respectively. Half-hearted swing right there. The count now 1-2 on him. Looks like Dominic Stagliano is the other one warming up in the pen for Stetson. He would be the righty, as that one is fouled out of play. Actually, correction, that is not Stagliano. That's actually Tanner Martin, who's one of the new additions to this Hatters roster, actually. He is the presumptive closer to start the year. Martin, a junior from Leesburg, comes to Stetson via Tallahassee Community College. Pretty solid pitcher at the JUCO level. Hard thrower. That one chopped hard toward second. Griffith backhands. Throw to first. In time! Side retired. Banks Griffith showing off the range. We head to the seventh inning stretch. We're still tied at three. You're watching Hatter Vision.
We're tied at three.
Thank you.
leading off the bottom of the seventh inning for your Hatters. The first baseman, number 23, Jacob Buller.
Jake Buller will lead us off here in the bottom of the seventh. 6, 7, and 8 hitters for the Hatters. First pitch from Ludman. Outside on Bullard, 1-0. Ludman now entering his seventh inning of work. He's a guy who's used to going long distances, had 3 complete games last year for the Blue Hens. The only 3 complete games that Delaware had all last year, actually. Ludman, 3-5 record with a 4.62 ERA in 2021. Pitched a team-high 78 innings. That one hit hard towards third. There's Joey Lloyd. Throw across for out number one.
Now the right fielder, number 5, Connor Keel.
So now Bullard 1-for-3 in the game. And Connor Keel will try to build off his success in the fourth. He got a single. That's where he was eventually stranded, though. Keel lays off the outside pitch there, 1-0. Lubman's pitch high there, 2-0. A lot of other A-Sun teams getting their season started today, of course, as Keel fouls that off. Nick Vera thought he could make a play on that, but he cannot. A-Sun still looking for its first win of the 2022 season. Although they're not too far away from getting that. In a couple places, actually. Including here. One A-Sun game already going final. As Keel lays off that one from the count now. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Virginia beating Bellarmine. 1-0 final there in the Jerry Bryson Classic in Boiling Springs, North Carolina. Keel bounces that towards third. Lloyd with the backhand, throw across the diamond for out number 2.
Now batting the catcher, number 34, Christian Pregent.
And here comes Christian Pregent. Lubman has now retired 8 out of the last 9 Hatters that he's faced. If you go all the way back to Keel's single in the fourth, the only one who's not been retired by him was Cameron Hill with his single in the fifth, but he got erased on the double play. Pregent lays off that one for strike 1. Christian Pregent, 3-year captain last year, 222 batting average, did have 3 homers and 13 RBIs. Awfully good at nailing runners from behind the plate, though. Had 12 runners thrown out in 30 attempts. Only 1 error all year. His defense behind the plate is certainly elite. And he can call a great game, too. Coaches would love to see him improve the bat, though. And there's some competition behind him on that front. The 1-1. As Pregent lays off, 2-1 the count. Pregent, the only returning catcher from last year's team. The rest of the catching group is brand spanking new. Craig Paladar, one of the new names. Daniel Labrador as well. Both could vie for playing time. As Pregent now down 2-2. Paladar and Labrador, both more offensive-minded catchers, though. Both with a lot of power, especially Labrador. Regent so far in this game 0-2. He's still looking for his first hit of the year. And you'll have to see at least one more pitch as that's fouled away. Stetson and Delaware knotted at 3 here, bottom of the 7th. The 2-2 from Ludman is low. That's a full count. Delaware head coach Jim Sherman going for his 800th win today, all time as a head coach. He'll be hanging up the cleats after this season, though. Talking to him before the game, he'd mentioned to me that that was something that had been on his mind for a while, that is retiring. And he felt like this would be a good year to do it, try to leave on a high note, on a roster that's certainly in transition, but Pregent lays off of that one. And he'll reach base for the first time this year. And that is Ludman's second walk of the game. Banks Griffith is 0-2 in this game. Retired the same way both times. Ground out the short, third and the fifth, respectively. Banks loves swinging at the first pitch. And he does so here. Hit hard in the right field, but Greenlee's there. Side retired. So, we enter the top of the eighth. With both teams still tied up with one another. At 3, you're watching Hatter Vision.
Having fun and enjoying the things that you love doing most can even be tough when you're tired. Introducing new Coca-Cola Energy. It has delicious Coke taste and energy to help you enjoy all of life's most fun moments and do it with a little more bounce in your step. Pick up an ice cold can today or grab another one to share with a friend and go have some fun. Show up with new Coca-Cola Energy. The energy you want, the taste you love.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please. Now pitching for your Hatters, number 33, Tanner Martin. Leading off the top of the eighth inning, the second baseman, number 17, John Weglars.
John Weglars, Joey Loind, Jake Dunyon, 2, 3, and 4 for Delaware, due up here in the top of the eighth, as we have a new hurler in the game for Stetson. Tanner Martin fires outside corner, 0-1 the count. Martin with, I think, what might be my favorite entrance song so far this year that I've heard for Stetson. Digging back classic there with Aerosmith's Back in the Saddle. I have to say, rather appropriate for a relief pitcher, especially one who plays for Stetson. Martin fires low, 2-1 the count. As you can tell from your video, Martin is a guy who can throw it hard. Maybe one of the harder throwers on the roster. Maybe the hardest, really. As that's a pop-up. Foul territory, third base side. Desereau ranging. Ball's there. It'll be ball, but he can't corral it. That was a real long run. And Weglars can thank his lucky stars. He's going to get to see at least one more. Now we're seeing action in the Delaware pen. We got a righty warming up. Looks like Mike Biasello. The 2-2. And Martin's fastball misses high and outside, full count. Biasello is the most experienced guy out of the Delaware pen. Certainly a guy that the Blue Hens have relied on in recent years. And Weglars is down swinging. So that's Stetson's seventh K of the game and the first for Tanner Martin. And Danny Garcia's final line, in case you're wondering. Seven innings pitched, seven hits, three runs, all of them earned on six Ks. Facing 28 batters and threw 92 pitches. And Chris Ludman's not too far away, I would say, from being pulled himself. He's already at 90 pitches, that is, as Tanner Martin fires for the strike there on Loind, who has not had a particularly great day so far. 0-3, K's in the first and in the fourth. Popped out the center in the fifth, and maybe a second pop out on a row here. Connor Keel ensures it. Out number two. And now Jake Dunyon will step in, the designated hitter. Offense has really slowed down for both sides in this one. Hatters getting on board with two runs in the second and then one in the fourth. Blue Hens would tie the game up in the fifth with a two spot of their own after scoring one in the fourth. We've not seen any runs since. Dunyon in this game, he's 1-3 with a single in the fourth. Hits that hard in the right field towards the foul line. On the run is Keel. Entering in the shadows, he makes the grab. So a 1-2-3 inning for Hatters pitching. The third in a row for them. Delaware hasn't reached since Weglars' RBI single in the fifth. We head to the bottom of the eighth with the score tied at 3. You're watching Hatter Vision.
HumansAreIncredible.com to learn more. Advent Health, the official hospital of Stetson Athletics. Florida Orthopedic Associates is the official team physician of Stetson Athletics. Don't let pain affect your game. For sports injuries, sprains, fractures, and breaks, if it hurts, see them first at their Orange City walk-in clinic for urgent orthopedic injuries. Offices also in Delaware, Orange City, Lake Mary, and New Smyrna Beach. Florida Orthopedic Associates, state-of-the-art care, close to home.
Attention, please. Now pitching for the University of Delaware, number 14, Mike Biasiello. Biasiello, 14. Now pitches for Delaware.
Just
number two, Cameron Hill.
Stetson and Delaware knotted at three. Bottom of the eighth here in Melching Field in the opening game of the Hatter Classic. Nearing the two-hour mark in this contest. It's gone pretty quick considering six runs have been scored, actually. Top of the order for Stetson. Cameron Hill, Kyle Ball, Nick DiPonzio. That's who's due up. New pitcher in the game for Delaware. And it's who we mentioned earlier, number 14, Mike Biasello. A guy who will probably be Delaware's main relief option moving forward this season. The righty fires inside. And the count now, two balls and a strike on Cameron Hill. Ludman finishes his day in pretty nice fashion, actually. Especially considering the way it started. Cameron Hill with two hits on the day. Unfortunately for him, he was erased both times on a double play. A 3-1. In for the strike. Biasello, a graduate, 5'11", 185, from Logan Township, New Jersey. One of eight graduates on this roster for Jim Sherman. Six of them are transfers, though. Him and Chris Lundman, the only two who aren't. The payoff hit towards first base under the glove of a diving Joseph Carpenter. And that is Stetson's seventh hit of the game. Now the line score is as even as it was when we began. Three runs for both sides, seven hits for both sides, no errors for both sides. And Kyle Ball trying his best here to avoid hitting into a 6-4-3. He's done it twice in this game. That first pitch of ball, 1-0. Our thanks to those of you who are watching us on Hattervision via YouTube. We hope you've enjoyed this one. It's certainly been a close game. A 1-0. Cameron Hill thought about going. He wisely went back. Nick Vera, the catcher, looking over at first like, come on, man. Hill's a guy who can swipe, though. He showed that in his time in Kentucky. 23 bags stolen in his 3 years there. Hill looking at Coach Trimper over in the third base coach's box for some guidance here. Hatters have had one swipe in this game. DiPonzio in the fourth. That's been the only attempt so far for the guys in the white. As Biasello fires high, 2-1. Biasello's mostly been a reliever in his time in Delaware. He has seen some time as a starter, though. 3-5 record all time for the Blue Hens with a 5.27 ERA. He's a guy with strikeout ability, averages 1K an inning. The 2-1, Hill's going. Throw to second, not in time. Great jump from Hill. And he swipes his first bag as a Stetson Hatter. And for the first time since the fourth inning, the Hatters have a runner in scoring position. Manhattan and Notre Dame also scheduled to face off tonight. 7 o'clock first pitch is the scheduled time for now. Was that a balk? lot of the Hatter fans thought it was. The man in blue says no, though. Nathaniel Starr, by the way, calling the balls and strikes in this one. Hank Heminen at first, Kevin Flay at third. Heminen now near the second base bag. And the 3-1 is high. So ball reaches for the first time this year via walk. And that's the third pass issued by Blue Hens pitching today. And that brings up Nick DiPanzio. And for the first time all game, we're going to see a conference on the mound. That's Jad Prakniak, the pitching coach for the Blue Hens. A coaching staff that is chock full of former Blue Hen players. As a matter of fact, Prakniak is the only one who's not a former Blue Hen, graduated from Rhode Island. Everyone else on the coaching staff is. Jim Sherman, of course, going for his 800th victory all time as a head coach, which includes 7 years as the head coach at Wilmington University. He's also not too far away from 600 wins all-time at Delaware. 19 wins shy there, so whether he gets there before he retires is a question, but Delaware is playing a full schedule this season for the first time in a while. They've got 55 games scheduled, including quite a few at home, 30 to be precise. DiPanzio with a bunt attempt, and he's probably breathing a huge sigh of relief after that. That was definitely not what the coaches drew up. He tried to get that down, and it popped up, and a lot of times when a bunt pops up like that, it is disaster. But DiPanzio will have another shot here. Corner infielders at the edge of the infield grass. DiPanzio squared the bunt again. Carpenter at first was thinking of charging. Loin at third also was thinking of the same. Freeman and Weglars at short and second, sticking to double play depth. You've got Hill at second, Kyle Ball at first. And the Hatters with their first real offensive threat since the fourth inning. Last time they've scored in this game. DiPanzio, he squares. Let's it go. One ball and a strike now on the former Demon Deacon. DiPanzio with a single in the fourth. Swiped the bag, scored a run. Cade in the first, grounded out to short his last time up in the sixth. And with a 1-1 count, does DiPanzio try to lay the bunt again? Throw over to second, that goes in the center. But Cameron Hill not able to move. Jordan Hutchins in center field playing pretty close. And that's no doubt what helped prevent the move up. Nick Vera, the catcher, calling out the signs to his defense here. Corner infielders are still drawn in, though. Outfield playing a little shallower than normal. Let's see if DiPanzio tries the bunt. He squares. He drops it right in front of the plate. Throw to third. Not in time. DiPanzio safe at first. Bases loaded. The first bunt wasn't a thing of beauty from DiPanzio, but that time, exactly like the coaches drew it up. And DiPanzio even safe in the process. And now with bases loaded and nobody out, it's the cleanup hitter, Trey Harmon, who steps in. Stetson in prime position to grab the lead here. Not to mention get some distance. If Harmon can get a hit into the outfield, especially. First pitch, foul tipped. Harmon in this game has reached only once. That came on a walk in the second. He did score. His last two times out, struck out swinging in the fourth, struck out looking in the sixth. Biasiello has really put himself in the fire here. His fourth batter in this inning, he's yet to get an out. The 0-1 gets the strike call. Nothing and two now on Harmon. More action in the Stetson pen. Rashesh Pandya, the former Clemson Tiger and Wofford Terrier, warming up. The 0-2. Harmon lays off. Appeal to first, denied. So the count now 1-2. As we're seeing some of the teams from the later games making their way in. The Notre Dame Fighting Irish, some of the players walking through the concourse area right now. Looks like they're already geared up for battle. 1-2. Harmon hits that in the left field. Not a lot of distance. Let's see if the runner from third goes. He does not. Hill will lay off. Not the most accurate throw from Aiden Kane in left, but it did the job. So Harmon flies out without driving in a run. And here comes the freshman, Johan Desereau. One of two Canadians on this roster, both of them from Quebec, actually. Desereau spent some time with TNXL Academy in Accoy before making his way to Stetson. First pitch, Desereau went after it and missed. Desereau in this game singled in the second, eventually scored. Had a line-out RBI in the fourth. Cade his last time up in the sixth. We're in the bottom of the eighth. Tied at three. Bases loaded for the Hatters, though, and one out. You've got Hill at third, Ball at second, DiPonzio at first, all of them. Excellent speed. As Desereau foul tips that to the backstop netting, 0-2. One point of emphasis for the coaches this year was how Hatter batters did with a two-strike approach. Desereau's going to have a chance here to show what that is. The 0-2. Foul tipped off the end of the bat. Desereau has also seen time in his career for Team Quebec. Actually won a Canada Cup for them back in 2017. A physics major here at Stetson. Biasiello taking his time, the 0-2. And yes, and Desereau's down swinging. And with two outs on the board, it's now up to Jacob Bullard. Give credit to Biasiello. He got himself in a pickle. But he's almost pulled himself out of it without giving up a run. almost, of course, being the operative word here. There's still very much danger lurking in Jake Bullard. First pitch is a ball. Bullard in this game, singled in the fourth. Hit a ground out RBI in the second. Also grounded out the third back in the seventh. Bullard, a guy who came out of nowhere to win the first base job this year. A 1-0. Lays off that one for the strike. Bullard was a walk-on when he joined the Stetson team last year. Really made big improvements over the summer, in the fall, and of course in training camp. Won the first base job where there was a lot of competition. The 1-1 is a popper in the center. Hutchins backing up, makes the grab, and Biasello is fired up as he should be. Hatters, bases loaded, no one out, and they cannot get a run across. We are through eight here in Melching, and we're still tied heading into the ninth. You're watching Hatter Vision.
Jeremiah's Italian Ice, a proud partner of your Stetson Hatters. Be sure to enjoy our new promotion every Sunday this season for Dollar Ice Sundays.
Stetson Hatter fans, Bud Light is proud to be the official beer of Stetson University. Making friends is Bud Light's business. And as part of this, Bud Light wants to remind everyone that choosing a designated driver is what good friends do. Bud Light, Daytona Beverages, and Stetson University. Thanks everyone for making a responsible choice in choosing a designated driver.
Leading off the top of the ninth inning, the first baseman, number 20, Joseph Carpenter.
Entering the top of the ninth, Tanner Martin back on the mound. First pitch to Joseph Carpenter, laced in the center field for a base hit. Carpenter wasting no time and getting his second hit of the game. Had an RBI double in the fourth. We are tied at three between Stetson and Delaware. Our thanks to all of you joining us here on Hatter Vision. I'm Asad Bendian. Charlie Franklin, the guy behind the camera, making sure everything stays nice and clean for you. Former Stetson Hatter star football player Donald Parham also helping us out on today's broadcast. Of course, he's been spending his time in the NFL. Most recently with the LA Chargers. I just dated myself there a little bit. Bunt attempt there from Freeman. Not a very good one. 0-1. This first game of the Hatter Classic. Certainly a tight one so far from both sides. Stetson had the lead by the end of the second inning. Eventually got the 3-1 Stetson before Delaware played their two in the fifth. And it's been nothing but neck and neck ever since. The 0-1 is fouled just to the left of our broadcast position here. Count now 0-2 on Freeman. Freeman in this game does have a single. It was credited in the second. He's popped out in his last two ABs. Throw over to first there is Bullard. Manages to save that one from getting behind him. Another throw over to first. And now Martin goes towards the plate, missing outside, one and two to count now on Freeman. Christian Pregent with the signs. Looks like he wants this outside. And that's a high bouncer towards second. Griffith is there. Steps on second for one. The throw to first. Double play. And the first double play all year from the Hatters defense comes at a great time. Two outs on the board. We've now seen three double plays so far in this game as Stetson pitching coach Dave Thurno will walk his way out there and have a chat with Tanner Martin. We still have some action in the Stetson pen, although I suspect this is probably more of a strategy conversation than it is anything else from Dave Thurno. No motion to the pen. That's something you'll see Thurno do on occasion. If he sees something that he thinks needs a quick correction, he's not above just walking out there and letting his guys know. Nick Vera steps in, the catcher, first pitch swinging, and he almost lost his shoes in the process. Big cut right there from the Floridian. He's the only Floridian on Delaware's roster, actually. As you might imagine, for the Blue Hens, this is a roster stacked with a lot of Northeast guys. 22 from the first state, another 9 from Pennsylvania, and 6 from New Jersey. The 0-2 from Martin is high. 1-2. Martin, the team's closer to begin the year. Obviously not a save situation, but a critical one nonetheless. And Vera down swinging. Tanner Martin with his second K of the day, and he's fired up about it. Teammates coming out to greet him as we head to the bottom of the ninth. If the Hatters don't score here, we're looking at extras. You're watching Hatter Vision.
Soldier boy, tough. Yeah, I got the new dad for y'all, call him Soldier Boy. Got to watch me and crank back 3 times from left to right.
Fans, don't forget your Hatters baseball team is back in action tomorrow afternoon versus Notre Dame with a start time of 4 p.m. Look forward to seeing you then.
Oh,
off the bottom of the ninth inning. The right fielder, number 5, Hunter Keel.
It's the bottom of the ninth. It's been a tight one. And it looks like we're looking at a dramatic finish one way or the other here for Stetson. As Biasello fires high to Connor Keel, 1-0. 7, 8, 9 hitters due up for the Hatters. Keel, Pregent, and Banks Griffith. Keel in this game has reached once on a single in the fourth. And lays off of that one. 2-0 the count. Two and zero here from Biasello, and Keel pops that up, foul territory. Vero might have a play though. Throws off the mask and just lost track of it. As that actually landed in the stands, he wouldn't have had a play on it anyway. That net in front of the stands there does a nice job keeping balls away, but real high poppers like that can get through. And it, as you saw, it did that time. The 2-1. And Keel swings through that one. So the count now 2-2 for the Minnesota native. The only such player on Stetson's roster, actually. Hatters managing to load the bases in the eighth with none out, but not able to drive across a run. The 2-2. And Keel down, looking for strike three.
Now the catcher, number 34, Christian.
Only the second time all game that a hatter's gone down looking. Now it's up to Christian Pregent, who did reach on a walk in the seventh. 0 for 2 otherwise, though. Ground out in the fifth. Cade in the fourth. Biasello fires high, 1-0. Pregent is a guy who has some power. 3 homers last year, 13 RBIs. Also hit a home run in limited action back in 2020, the COVID-shortened season. The 1-0. And Pregent looks at that one. 1-1 the count. Banks Griffith waiting on deck. He's yet to reach today. He's 0 for 3. Four times in this game, the Hatters have gone down 1-2-3. It won't happen here, though. Christian Pregent with a single. Pregent with a nice time to get his first hit of 2022. Or actually, I guess I should say that if it is going to be a 1-2-3 inning for Stetson, it won't be the traditional kind. Delaware has gotten 2 double plays today already. Both of them of the 6-4-3 variety in the first and in the fifth, involving Cameron Hill and Kyle Ball. Hill's on deck as Banks Griffith steps up. Pregent with a short lead on first, and Griffith lays off the high stuff. Banks Griffith, the former Furman Paladin, came to the Stetson program once Furman shut down their baseball program, finding a home at Stetson, and has certainly seen a lot of playing time since he's been here. And that will certainly help his cause to get more of it. Another single driven to the left side of the field. And now with Christian Pregent at second and Banks Griffith at first, it's Cameron Hill who's due up. And the coaches are going for a little strategy. Christian Pregent has been lifted. That is Dylan Brazel, who's now pinch running. Dylan Brazel, one of the fastest runners on the Stetson roster. Matter of fact, a lot of speed on the bases right now. Griffith definitely no slowpoke himself. But his run doesn't matter for right now. It's Dylan Brazel at second that matters, as the pitch from Biasello misses. 1-0 the count now on Hill. He's had himself a pretty good start to his Stetson career. 3-for-4, all of them singles. First, fifth, and the eighth. Taken out on double plays in the first and in the fifth. And he lays off that one. 2-0. Hill got all the way to third in the eighth inning, and that's where he was stranded as the Hatters left the bags full without pushing a run across. But if Hill can find a way to get his fourth hit, it could be the game winner, especially if he goes into the outfield. Brazel definitely has the speed. A lot of people watching this one in silence, especially the Notre Dame baseball team, which is sitting in unison right above the first base dugout. The 2-0 is hit into center, but caught by Jordan Hutchins. For a second, I thought that went over his head, and it would have been ball game if that's the case, but it was not. The graduate made the right move there, and Hill is down for the second out of this inning. And now, it is up to Kyle Ball, a graduate himself. It's been a rough day for Kyle Ball. He's hit twice into a double play in the first and in the fifth. Grounding out to first and the third. Did walk in the eighth and was eventually stranded at second. But he can erase the rough day with one good hit here. Biasello fires high, 1-0. Bottom of the ninth, two outs. Stetson and Delaware knotted at three. If the Hatters can plate one here, it'll be a walk-off. The 1-0 is in the dirt. If Delaware can win it, it'll be the 800th win for Jim Sherman as a head coach. What a way to get it too, huh? If that were to happen. 2-0. Biasello gets the strike. With Pregent being lifted, if this game goes into extras, we're going to see a new catcher. I would imagine either Paladar or Labrador. We've got another Hatter warming in the pen just in case. The 2-1. And that hit ball! So bases loaded again.
The left fielder, number 11, Nick DiPonzio.
And now it's Nick DiPonzio with the chance to be the hero. Dylan Brazel now at third. Banks Griffith now at second. Kyle Ball now at first, although for all intents and purposes, Griffith and Ball don't matter. It's Dylan Brazel's run that matters. And Delaware wants to talk it over. Pitching coach Jad Prakniak out there talking some strategy. No action in the Blue Hens' pen, so looks like they're going to ride with Biasello no matter what. We are nearing the 2.5 hour mark in this contest. Manhattan and Notre Dame set to play at 7 o'clock tonight. We'll have that game for you, of course, on Hatter Vision. I'll be pulling double duty there. But before we get to that game, we still got to finish this one. Two outs on the board, and DiPonzio lays off. 1-0 the count. DiPonzio in this game, he's had two singles. In the fourth, he scored a run after swiping a bag. Bunted his way on in the eighth to load the bases, but he wouldn't go any further than first. Also, Cade in the first, grounded out the short in the sixth. The former Deben Deacon with a chance to give Stetson its first win of the year in style. Lays off of the off-speed there, 1-1. The 1-1. And Biasello fires low. 2-1 now. DiPonzio last year finishing with a .224 batting average and four homers. Although, to be fair to Nick, a lot of his season got derailed after he hurt his leg. The 2-1. It's hit hard. If that stays fair, it's over. It's over! Dylan Brazel trots home from third. Nick DiPonzio is running away from his teammates, but not for long. Hatters 4, Delaware 3. And Stetson gets its first victory of the season in style. Hatters walking it off here on Nick DiPonzio's game-winning single, driving home Dylan Brazel from third. Delaware falls to 0-1 on the season. Jim Sherman's wait for number 800 is going to have to wait for at least one more game. For them, that will come at noon tomorrow against the Jaspers of Manhattan. Manhattan, in the meantime, is gearing up for Notre Dame, which is set to start within 90 minutes. 7 o'clock first pitch. We'll have it for you right here on Hatter Vision. As for the Hatters, this will be their only game on Hatter Vision this weekend, at least scheduled. Both the games for the Hatters on Saturday and Sunday, we migrate over to ESPN+. Myself and Evan Weston will be on the call for those. First pitch for the Notre Dame game tomorrow, 4 p.m., a game that's already sold out, by the way. So if you were looking to get tickets, you might be out of gas. Stetson will also take on Manhattan Sunday at 1 p.m., but we'll talk more about that down the line. It's been a pleasure, folks. Hatters get their first win of the year, 4-3. Nick DiPonzio with the game-winning RBI single. For Charlie Franklin, our cameraman, Donald Parham producing, and the rest of us here on Hatter Vision, I'm Asad Bendian. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you in 90 minutes as Notre Dame takes on Manhattan. Until then, have a good one, folks.